This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Audio.
The bounty hunter failed. Fetch me the Jedi.
Your apprentice failed.
You will fail, Jedi.
Damn, guys, this was insane. It was my biggest project ever, and I must say, I f***ing loved it. I enjoyed every last bit of it, and believe me, this mini short story will definitely have a sequel. But because it was a bigger project, we thought to ourselves, we need help. And luckily we had fellow YouTuber Inya Zalea come to our aid, ready to help us with his 3D and visual effects expertise. I would highly recommend this channel to all filmmakers interested in visual effects. He does a wide variety of in-depth tutorials, and he even did a video about the 3D ship in this Star Wars short movie. He explains his workflow and how to composite 3D objects. So go check that out, I'll leave a link for that in the description below. However, Inyas wasn't the only help we had. We also had the Red Giant plugin for After Effects, which made VFX life much easier for us. For instance, this Force Blast, which we made with a Red Giant tutorial and their plugins. Red Giant is a tool I would absolutely recommend. Again, a link in the description below. Now guys, I already saw the last Star Wars movie. Believe it or not, but my pal JJ Abrahams and I did a quick screening, because he wanted to know my thoughts about it. And I must say, yeah, no, I'm just kidding about JJ Abrams. I did see the movie though, 2 days ago. Here in Belgium, the premiere was on the 18th. And as a huge fan, I couldn't not go. That's why Jill and me went to that premiere. And guess what? It was a marathon of the last 3 Star Wars movies. It was awesome, just awesome. And do you want to know who died? Well, it's... Sorry, I would never spoil a movie. No, that's something I really, really hate. But I think it's time now to start with the effect. And the effect that we are recreating today is the iconic Force choke of the Sith Lords. For this effect, you'll need 2 shots, a camera movement and of course an empty shot on a tripod. This tripod shot can be quite simple. Just film your Sith Lord over shoulder. In the shot you can let him lift up his hand, pretending to choke somebody. Then the second shot will be the green screen shot. But we are going to use a camera movement for this. Let your actor stand in front and on the green screen while he pretends to be suffocating. Then aim your camera towards him while holding it high in the air. Over time, lower the camera but keep the framing on your actor. This lowering camera movement will add a perspective change on your actor and will help with selling the effect. You can perfectly do this handheld as we will stabilize it afterwards. However, do try to keep it as steady as possible. Okay, now that we have our shots, let's begin with the post-production. Of course we are doing this effect in After Effects, because it will need some clever stabilizing tricks. So in After Effects, place your empty shot into a new composition and the green screen shot on top of that. Then select your green screen shot and look for the warp stabilizer inside the tracker panel. Click on that and let After Effects do its thing. Once it's done, go to the effects control panel and open up the advanced option of the warp stabilizer effect. Here you can enable the show track points option, which will show you the track points of the effect, obviously. What we now want to do is select all the track points around our actor and delete them. Do this for the entire length of the clip. This means go 20 frames further in time, select the track points and delete. Repeat and delete. Just don't delete any points that sit on the actor. When you are done, you can disable the show track points option and change two settings in the effect. The first one is result, which you can set to no motion. The second setting is the method, which needs to be on position, scale and rotation. Okay, now we will already have a green screen clip that is stabilized on the actor. The next step is to key out the green. So look for the key light effect and drag that to your green screen shot. And you know the drill. Use a color picker to select the green, fine tune with the clip black and white, and maybe even use the shrink and softness option to remove the edge. If you still have some grain in your shot, you can always adjust the replace method to hard color. This will sometimes help with removing the grain. And like with all green keying, let's create a mask to cut away the rest of the clip. Due to the camera movement and the perspective change, your mask will probably go wrong throughout the clip. That's why we need to animate the mask so that it follows along with your actor. The next step is to position and scale your actor so that he stands on the right spot. Then enable the animation for the position of the actor and let him move up in the air. Try to match the movement of the Sith Lord's arm so that it looks like he's lifting him up with the force. Of course, use ease out on the first keyframe and ease in on the last. When you have done this, let's fine tune the motion a little bit more. Select the position property and go in the graph editor. Here you can now determine the speed of the ease out and the ease in. I want to make the movement in the beginning faster, so drag the lever closer to the keyframe. Now do the opposite for the last keyframe and drag the lever further away, making the movement slower towards the end. This will now already leave you with your actor being lifted up in the air by the force. However, we can still add some more details to the effect. But first, let's check on Jordi. He had something really cool in store for us.
Oh, hi there. It's me, Jordi. Droid. Star Wars Droid, that's right. And you know what? Where I got these very cool robot sound effects from? That's right, from Storyblocks Audio, our sponsor today. Storyblocks Audio is an incredible library packed with sound effects, music and loops. For almost every project, we do our sound design using audio blocks, like we also did with the intro film of this tutorial. And besides the sound effects, you can also search for music. There are various genres that you can use in personal but also in commercial projects. And finally are loops, which can help you to create your own music score. How cool is that? And you know what's even cooler than that, guys? There's only a single price per year or per month, which allows you to download the entire library if you like so. So make sure to click that first link in the description down below to start downloading right away.
Oh. Whoops. Back to you, Janik.
What? I don't know what I just saw. How did he become a droid? And a bad droid. Anyways, let's find out after the rest of the effect. And let's start with the first detail, which is a small motion on the empty background. First, scale the clip up with 10%. Then with the position, let the clip move down. This small movement will enhance the force lift and will help sell the effect. Another thing missing to make the effect more realistic is the shadow. For this, you can duplicate the empty layer and place it between the two shots we already have. Then in the effects library, look for the Lumetri effect and drag that to the duplicate. Now in the effects control panel, you can make the clip more bluish and decrease the exposure, but only a little bit. Then adjust the blending mode of the duplicate clip and set it to multiply. Draw a mask where you want the shadow to be and feather to your liking. You can look at the shadows of other objects in your shot to match your fake one. Then when the actor moves up in the sky, animate the mask and the feather along. Increase the feather a bunch and make the mask bigger and farther removed from the actor. Now the last detail is not necessary, but can make it more fun. Now if you want, you can always add dust around your actor to really show off the power of the force, We just used stock clips we found on Storyblocks, but you can use whatever. And this will leave you with a very cool Star Wars effect.
You're probably thinking, Jordy, what are you doing? Well, I am motion capturing my motion. That's right. This right here is an Ixen suit, which was sent to us. Unfortunately, it's a loan suit, so we're gonna have to send it back, or not. And what it basically does is capture my motion into the 3D program of Ixen itself. You can see here, into the smallest details, it is capturing everything. And what's cool about it as well is that it is completely wireless, so I can just start running around and the program will stay capturing my motion wherever I go. How cool is that? So the suit has a bunch of sensors in it, and you know, that's basically it. It actually works super simple. Capturing the motion went super easy, but then comes the hard part. You need to link your motion capture thing into a 3D program. It works with everything, like with Cinema 4D, 3DS Max, Maya, whatever that you like. But you know, you need to know something about that program. So we had a little bit of trouble there because we didn't have much time to figure it all out. Mostly Janik put his time in there. But that is the 3D side of things. You need to know something about shading, about textures, how to model maybe, how to link your motion capture thing to a specific model that you have. You know, that's a different story. Maybe in a couple of months or so, when we get to practice more in that program, we can do it a little bit better. But until now, I mean, the motion looks good, right? Mm. So a big thanks to Ixens for letting us borrow this suit. It was a really awesome experience for us. If you'd like to check out more about this suit as well, you can find the link somewhere in the description down below. And now, Janik, back to you.
Well, Jordy, that is a coincidence. I also wanted to talk about motion capture in my Janik's Fun Fact Fountain. Everybody knows that in the early Star Wars movies, they mostly used practical effects. Even the droids back then were humans in suits. But lately they are using aliens that just cannot be recreated by practical effects, such as Dobu Skye from The Last Jedi. This was a very small drunken alien who can be seen inserting coins in BB-8. But the fun fact about this is that the alien is played by Mark Hamill himself. Yeah, you heard me. Luke Skywalker is also a very small, drunken gambler alien. Nice to know. But, like you can guess, it's almost impossible to stick a human in such a small alien suit. We can try, of course. However, I don't think Mark Hamill will like you afterwards. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the Star Wars video as much as I did. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Audio, for the support. And as always, keep sending us your copycat ideas in the comments below. And oh yeah, stay creative.
Thank you, Jordy, for this lovely 3D experience. Now I hate shaders, lighting, and animations. What I hate even more is rendering. It's rendering for 4 hours. 4! It's like 3:30 now. Damn it, Jordy!